Hello everyone and welcome to a new episode of Meet Up Talent series by ETHR World. Today we have with us Vivek Tripathi, Head of Human Resources at AU Bank, which is the largest small finance bank of India. Vivek has about 15 years of rich experience in HR in banking and NBFCs. His professional experiences include executive level management, culture building, people development, performance management, stakeholders management, HR strategy, OD, talent management, CSR, and business strategy. He has a diversified experience working with large institutions as well as with startups. Prior to working with AU, he was designated as Chief Human Resource Officer and Head Customer Service for SBFC Finance Private Limited. Welcome, Vivek.
Thank you so much, Apriksha. Thank you so much.
So Vivek, the pandemic has surely changed how we interact and do business and the way organizations, you know, do work planning and obviously recruiting and hiring. So the first question to you is, how has your hiring strategy changed concerning sourcing, selection and pipeline management post the pandemic?
Yeah, thank you, Apriksha, for your question. So pandemic has changed everything, Apriksha, you know. So if you talk about sourcing, so earlier, you know, our source mix was different. We were having more walk-ins. If there's a newspaper advertisement, we were having more, you know, people in our offices. But after this pandemic, you know, we as a sensible institution, we were also discouraging, you know, gathering due to COVID protocol, as well as, you know, candidates, they never wanted to come because of the COVID protocol. So everything has changed, right? So now, we are not having, you know, that kind of footfall, right? And again, our major tool was to, you know, place newspaper advertisement. We were getting lots of application, lots of people. But with the help of this pandemic, I will say help, because we got new avenues of hiring. We are concentrating more on search engines, right? So our ratio has been changed. Earlier, it was around 20% from search engine. It has reached to 40%. We are using social media, right? So there are lots of things which we are doing now. Most difficult part in sourcing is what? You know, we have to hire somebody, right, whom we have not met. So traditionally, what was happening? We were meeting everybody, you know, then we were finalizing. But now with the help of Teams, because everybody is available, and we have just changed our strategy. We are not focusing. Earlier, it was like we have to meet people. And we have to then finalize. Now things has been changed. Our strategy is to have video call through Teams, understand the profile and hire. As far as your second point is selection. For selection also, earlier all the screening were happening through line manager or through HR. Again, here also we have introduced digital aspect. We are doing screening through video, right? We have done tie-up with few of the vendors. For technical roles, we are doing screening through that. And as far as pipeline is concerned, you know, it has two legs for me. One, external hiring. For example, we are a growing company. If you know about our company, we are growing 40% year on year. Our manpower growth is 25%. We have 24,000 employees across nation. And we feel in 5 years time, we may touch around 75,000, right? So in that part, we have to have, you know, pipeline. So what we are doing? Other than traditional hiring, you know, social media hiring, that is one part which we are the bridge is for temporary hiring. We are doing all these things, but yes, there has to be pipeline because the way we are growing. So what we are doing, we are focusing on STD model, hire, train, deploy model. We are focusing more into campus placement. You know, then we are also talking about internal thing. We are using IJP process so that we can also upgrade our internal skill. We are focusing more on training so that our internal employee get trained and they can, you know, get the new roles within the company. So for pipeline is two way for me, which I said for our growth perspective, we are doing lots of new thing, including summer intern. Earlier, you know, we were having summer interns, but we were not giving them, you know, we were not exploring them as future employee. So now we have also started that kind of scenario where somebody is doing good, we are also offering them. And again, we have done tie-up with few of the company. I think you must be knowing about Tata. They have their own platform wherein they provide screened engineers to, you know, different of company as per requirement. We have also done tie-up with them. So we are also getting pipeline from this kind of institution also. So we have just spread our wing. Earlier we were, you know, only related with, you know, hiring related to 1 month or 2 months timeline. Now we are focusing, can we foresee 1 year hiring plan, and accordingly we are planning entire scheme of things.
That's great to know, Vivek. So while we're talking about recruitment, we would like to know that what kind of skills do you look for while hiring across functions in your organizations? Obviously, there has been a lot of talks around behavioral skills these days, but what would be some of those key skills, technical or soft skills or behavioral skills that you focus on while hiring?
So, you know, as we have legacy of 26 years, as I said, and we are India's largest small finance bank. So we have your skill matrix for all the roles. That is competency framework. Basis each role, we have competency framework, and we ensure basis those framework, we hire people, right? So there are, if there is a fresher, we ensure we match value system in interview. And then again, we have our principles also. This is in Hindi, that is Imandari, Samajdari, and Zimmedari, right? Because we want people, whosoever is joining us, they should be honest, they should be responsible, and they should be intelligent enough, right? And we focus on our AU Dharma, which is our value. So we put focus more on integrity, customer focus, right? So these are the set of things which we have in company. So we cannot say that we only focus on skill or maybe some of the attributes. It's a combination of all. If I am hiring somebody in digital or technical role, yes, technical skills are required. That is a demand nowadays. As you know, post-pandemic, what has changed for me? So we are shifting toward digital, right? But along with these digital, you know, technical knowledge, we also see a leadership competency under the framework. That is what I see. We do not only hire a skill, we also hire attitude, right attitude for AU Bank.
That's great, Vivek. So there has been a lot of changes, in fact, a paradigm shift in terms of job expectations, skill set requirement, which you have already talked about, which has obviously redefined the work and workplaces. So technology, digitization have given a further push to work aspects. In this regard, how do you see jobs evolving in your sector?
So job, if you see post-pandemic, you know, we are bank, and again, we have to have model where we are available everywhere, right? So initially 2-3 years, we were available, we were opening more branches, we were hiring more people. But post-pandemic, we realized customer has changed his mindset up. He does not want to come to branch for any transaction. He wants to operate everything from his house, right? So that is the era where customer is more into digital. He wants to do everything from mobile banking. Therefore, we have also launched our 0101 app, right? So which is the one of the beautiful app. What all it has? It had video banking. Likewise, the way we are talking, we AU Bank can open your account from here only, right? Since we are the only small finance bank of India, it has its own credit card and QR code. And all has happened only because of digital. So my requirement, job requirement has two legs now. One is physical and another is digital. That is physical. For physical, yes, we have to hire people, you know, banking industry, right? People who are experienced, but in digital era, the requirement is huge. So for me, my shift has been changed to digital more, because what we understand, if we have to reach in every part of India, digital is the only way by which we can reach to everyone. We cannot open maybe 50 lakh branches to reach across. So we are focusing more. The job has evolved towards digital more. We want to have people who understand digital. That therefore, in company also, we are running a training program called Smart Bankers. We are making them smart. Smart for us, the guy who knows basics of digital, who can make customer also understand the reason why he should not come to, you know, branches, how he can operate everything from his own house. So for me, shift toward digital is there for us.
Thank you, Vivek, for that. In fact, you know, belonging to an industry which never practically stopped working in all these years, for last 2.5 years when everything was remotely working, but the banking sector was one, you know, which obviously it came to the digital front, but the physical environment, the work environment, that didn't stop working. People were going to offices in this sector. So to close the circle on recruitment, which we were talking about, we talked about recruitment practices and skill gaps and all those things. What is some of the particular or maybe the biggest challenge that you see in the TA space at this moment, considering you're part of one of the complex structure of sectors that India has?
So you rightly said, Apeksha, we are part of essential service. So we are very honored that we are part of essential services as like doctors, right? So because of, you know, we had to fulfill, you know, expectation of customer. Therefore, we had to work throughout the year in pandemic also. And we are very, very, very honored that we did fantabulous job, you know, and as a company also, you know, we promoted lots of initiative for our employees, right? So that they can be secured. We run PCS program, you know, wherein 2 months ago, we have vaccinated our 98% population, right? So we from company level, we did everything for people, you know, unfortunately, whatever life we have lost, we sponsored, you know, interim relief for family, 2-3 years salary, sponsorship to their, you know, kids also, right? But coming to your question, what kind of difficulties I am facing in TA space? So, you know, this is universal difficulty for any HR guy, be it India, be it anywhere, getting right talent at right time. This is the first one. But post pandemic, that has been changed. Now people want remote working, right? Why? Why? Because they want security. Earlier, people used to live only for money, but now they have changed their mindset. They believe they want their families and their social economical things more than a job, right? So these are the challenges which we are facing. At senior level also, you know, people are not able now, still now, to come for personal round of interview. And again, as an HR, my job is to convince somebody to hire a guy whom he has not met, right? So these are the challenges. The first foremost is working from remote. As you rightly said, we are part of essential service. But what we have to do, as AU Bank is, you know, agile bank, what we have done, we have identified roles, few roles, who can work from anywhere, right? So we have started giving flexi hours to our people. We have started giving work from home. We have started giving work from anywhere facility, right? So these all we are doing as a bank, you know, so that we can have, you know, good talent. And one scenario is what happens if we look for senior resources and they have to shift themselves from one place to another place. What is the biggest situation from them? How they will get admission for their kids? So for example, in Jaipur, we have done tie-up with 5 good schools and we are assisting our employee to get the admission of their kids also. So we are just trying to create ecosystem as like FinTech has. So because we have to be agile, because we want to become India's largest digital bank.
Sure, Vivek, thank you. So as you know, slightly touched upon the fact that organizations do work to get, you know, good talent. So businesses globally are largely talking about having the diversity, equity and inclusion programs in their workplaces. But it always, you know, important to go to the next level. So please tell us something about your DE&I agenda and how do you plan to take it further?
So you just see our structure. We are a bank. We are available in 15 states, right? So there is the diversity by default. We have more than, you know, 20 lakh customer. Right. So there's a diversity in terms of, you know, religion, gender, caste, education, age, everywhere there is a diversity. Right. We are talking more about how we become inclusive because diversity is a part and parcel. It's going to happen. But how we ensure we have, you know, climate and work culture where everybody is welcome with their thought, with their origin, with their culture, for which we have created in-house. We have Diversity Inclusion Council, which has been chaired by our MD and CEO. And all these CXOs, they are part of that committee member. Now you have, maybe you will talk, you want to know more about what is the focus area. So every year we sit and we decide what should be the focus area. Likewise, what we really believe, it's only 4.5 years, how we can increase gender diversification. As of now, we are we have 8 to 10% female staff with us. We feel we should focus more on into this, as well as how we can create employment for physically able, especially able, you know, applicants, right? And again, how we are also believing how we can create, you know, source mix for, you know, people who are qualified in different segment. So these are the focus area for diversification for us. Is it's not an agenda, right? It's a way of life, because we cannot discriminate. As we are bank, as a bank, we have to accept all the, you know, customers. And after this digitization, digital never understand whose caste is what, whose gender is what. As like, as a bank also, we are here to welcome all the talent in terms of gender, caste, and religion, and providing one platform where they feel inclusive. Inclusiveness is the key for me, and we are driving this. And I think in 3-4 years timeline, there would be lots of things which would be. I think you will appreciate few of the initiative which we are going to take.
We are pretty sure, Vivek. Yeah. So those were some great thoughts and insights which you shared with us. Thank you for your time and for joining us today for this interaction.
Thank you, Apeksha. I really enjoyed this interaction, and thank you for giving time the privilege that I can talk about my company. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Vivek.